So let's say I am working for a company that's a contractor, all right, and I'm working on somebody's house, and my employer, the contractor, doesn't carry workers' comp insurance for me, then I would file for the uninsured employer's fund and try and, you know, get my client immediate benefits, but I would also file a claim against the homeowner's insurance. Because a lot of homeowners insurance policies have provisions wrapped up in them that deal with injuries that occur on the job, or if somebody is doing a job, and that offer the homeowner protection, because potentially there would be a claim against the homeowner for their failure to hire a company that carries workers' comp insurance. So there's that. And then the other piece of all of this, right, is that, so if I work for, let's say a company, a contracting company, and I do, floors, right? But then there's a general contractor, and the general contractor is obviously managing the entire project. So if I work for the flooring company and my company does not have workers' comp insurance, then I'm allowed to go after the general contractor, who would absolutely have to carry workers' comp insurance. So if the sub is uninsured, we still pursue the uninsured employer's fund for that, but there is now insurance. And again, my concern is never, I don't care who's paying, as long as somebody's taking care of the benefits for my injured worker, I don't care, right? Hey, Ted, I don't care. The answer is that as long as my client is getting the benefits that they are absolutely entitled to, doesn't matter to me who's paying. And it's interesting. There's a couple of contexts in which I say that. And one of which is if we have a client who is totally disabled, or we think is totally disabled, I don't care who's going to pay that client. Somebody's going to pay that client for the rest of their life. I don't care who. So I'll go after anybody. Somebody's going to pay my client. So, again, when it comes to these situations, it's really difficult. And, like everything else right now, I was just commenting the other day, I was talking to my partner, and we were talking about this from the standpoint that I find myself fighting from the get-go on a workers' compensation case these days, which didn't happen, that was not happening pre-COVID. And I'll give you an example, right? I have a client who the authorized doctor says needs physical therapy, and they're not authorizing the physical therapy. So I am fighting right now to get treatment right up front in the case that's being recommended by the authorized treating physician. To me, it makes no sense whatsoever. So here are the responses I get from the attorney. I'll reach out to the adjuster. Oh, the adjuster isn't in this week. I'll reach out to the supervisor. Oh, the supervisor said that they got to do this or that. I'm like, days are going by and they haven't authorized the physical therapy. The physical therapy that is required by law and is being recommended by their own doctor. So fine. So I filed a motion for medical benefits because they're screwing around. And it makes no sense. This is the stuff we should not be fighting about. This is the stuff that is supposed to absolutely be happening. But this is the problem. Because now it's going to take me 30 days to get in front of a judge. Okay. I filed my motion, 30 days, right? And what's going to happen? What's going to happen is at some point along the road, they're going to authorize the physical therapy. My client will start the physical therapy. And by the time I get in front of a judge, what's going to happen? They're going to be like, oh, Sam, what's the problem? Therapy got authorized. I'm like, right. But it didn't get authorized until I had to file a motion. Are you kidding? Here's email one, judge. Here's email two. Here's email three. They didn't do anything about it. They're working on it. Well, you know what? I'm working on it too. So it's crazy. Now, where the fight should be taking place is in the values of cases. How much is it worth at the end? What do we want? What is best for our client? Or if there's really truly an issue. That is, you know, maybe 2 weeks earlier you fell at home and then you fell at work. Okay, well, there might be an issue as to where, you know, who's responsible. And I get that. And that's okay. That's okay. Let's fight about that. Or let's just work through it. Or let's just resolve this and then my client can treat with their own doctor, you know, whatever. But that I at least understand. But the nonsense, either not paying correctly, not paying for medical treatment, not authorizing medical treatment that's being recommended by their own doctor, this is not what we should be fighting about. But that's what we're dealing with every single day. Every single day, what I'm fighting about, the emails I get, all of the things that I am dealing with for hours every day is the nonsense of workers' comp insurance companies completely taking advantage of the way in which the system is evolving to this virtual, you know, non-touching thing, and it's just creating a mess. And they know they can get away with it. I mean, that's the bottom line. Because again, by the time I get there, what's going to happen is they're going to have authorized. Then they're going to look at me like, well, just withdraw your motion. I'm like, no, I get an order and then I'm going to want a fee because you didn't do what you were supposed to do, despite the fact that you're emailing me telling me that you're working on it. I don't care that you're working on it. Good job, but you didn't get it done. So now here's an extra kick in the ass. And now you're going to have to pay a fee in order for being stupid, not authorizing what was originally recommended in the first place.